appreciate you joining us, and appreciate all those that joined us yesterday for our Sunday time together in worship, and also the 5 o'clock service and 11 o'clock service both. We're going to look at different scriptures this week. We're going to go ahead and change things up. We'll maybe get back to Moses and as he leads the children of God into the wilderness and beyond. But let's go ahead and look at an Old Testament scripture that we hear all the time. I heard it even before I was coming to church and before I accepted the Lord. I heard it all the time as a little kid, and it's Ecclesiastes 11:1. Cast your bread on the surface of the waters, for you will find it after many days. Now, a lot of times, you know, when those name it, claim it, or send me $5, you'll get 500 in return or whatever, trying to get people to donate things. They use this a lot, and they always forget, for you will find after many days. You know, they, we can't expect immediate return on it. I hear the scripture quoted quite a bit, but have not taken much time out to look at it. So let us dive in today. My beloved, we live in a time where folks have very demanding and also attitudes of getting things fast, and getting a fast return even on our investments. So we see that in this day of microwaves, in this day of fast food, in this day of all these things, we kind of expect to get a quick return on the bread we cast out on the water. But we see that when we cast our bread on the water, we must not expect to see immediate returns. The truth is, we may not see these returns this side of heaven. And we're not told that very often, but we have to understand that. And when you do something for the Lord, which is casting your bread, or ask the Lord for something, sometimes the answers just don't come, and sometimes the profits don't be returned. You need to do things for the Lord with no expectations of stuff being returned. But there are times when you need to seek an answer, and so you cast your bread out on the water. We also are living in a time where more and more people are doing things and expecting something in return. And that is not casting your bread on the water, expecting something in return, immediate return. And so you cast your bread on the water knowing that someday it'll come back to you. It's sort of like I hear people say all the time, well, karma will turn around and bite you, or karma will do this. But we see that casting your bread on the water is a different thing. The history is very interesting. The Egyptians cast their seeds onto the waters of the Nile, where it might seem a sheer waste of corn and grain, but in due time the floods subsided and the rice or the other grains sank into the fertile mud, and rapidly a harvest is produced. And that's what it is the Egyptians used to cast out their seeds on the Nile, and it seemed like a waste until the Nile went down and those seeds were put into fertile ground and grew relatively quickly in that fertile ground. Let us today do good on the thankful and the evil people around us. Let us teach in love the careless and hatred the people sometimes come in contact with is not the right thing. We need to put things out there for the Lord. We need to do things for the Lord, cast our bread on the water for the Lord, and know that that eventually it'll come back to us. Unlike waters may cover hopeful soil, nowhere shall our labor be in vain when the Lord is the one who seeks to be glorified. So even though it was seemed like it was in vain to cast those seeds on the water, we see that anything we do for the Lord is never in vain. And anything we do for the Lord is casting our bread on the water, and we'll have a return for it, maybe not in this life, but in the life to come as Christians. It is our obligation to cast our bread onto the waters. It remains with God to fulfill the promise, for you will find it after many days. Wow. Isn't that great? Cast your bread on the water today. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, give us the courage, give us the determination to cast our bread on the water, even when we don't think it makes sense, even when we don't have the human desire to do it. Let us glorify you in all things, and let us seek doing things and casting our lives on the water for you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.